to London Fashion Film Festival FFChat. My name is Bailey and I am here today with John Dunn, who is the director of the film Reawaken, which was nominated for Best Visual Effects and Special Effects at London Fashion Film Festival 2017. So, John, thank you very much for joining us today.
No problem at all.
So maybe to get us started, tell us a bit about your background and how you got into filmmaking.
I studied design to a master's degree level, and communication and basically how to tell stories in, you know, all different forms. So mostly advertising forms, so always promos, trying to kind of give something that the audience can understand and take away some kind of message from it. So it's always been something that I've done. I was in my early 20s, right up to now. So studying design kind of really always opened my eyes to new things, and, you know, seeing how people can convey a message. So that's what's taken me into storytelling, to making short films and, you know, making things that kind of people can relate to. Mm.
What is it about fashion film that interests you particularly?
I love the braveness of it, because it can be, you know, you can do anything. There's no rules or rhyme or necessarily any reason to what someone can put out there. It's about grabbing the audience, making them think, and I love that. Mm-hmm. Do you know what I mean? I think there's a lot that can be done with something like that. You know, it's probably one of the braver areas of, you know, telling stories, where you can put things together that don't necessarily make sense unless you know the story behind it, but then when you do, it actually does.
Yeah.
I like that.
Tell us about Reawaken. How did you come up with that concept?
So again, working with a fashion designer, independent fashion designer, she makes amazing clothes. Her name's Kodaki. We sat down and we had a good discussion about her brand and what she wanted her brand to kind of really say, and what the message of her. The word colicky means queen of eagles, but we didn't want to just go down that straight, okay, what does the word colicky mean? Just go down that straight narrative. We wanted to try and make it something that was a bit more about, okay, how does someone feel when they're wearing a dress by a colicky? How does someone feel when, you know, they have things to say, but not necessarily can say it, but the dress says it. So we really tried to come up with something that was, again, not direct in what it is that her brand's name is, but how we were going to make the audience feel when they saw the piece and how they felt about the whole kind of experience of the dress. So that's kind of what we did there. So it was a lot of kind of, what can we do here? How can we make this happen? But I think in the end we kind of came up quite a good solution just by sitting down and mapping out ideas, you know, coming up with something that really made her dresses, or this particular dress particularly, feel, you know, quite powerful and emotive, you know, so that's what we want to get across.
So when you're working on a fashion film, do you always come from the brand first, or is there a time when the narrative...
I think, again, you know, it's depending on who you're working with, some people are more giving than others. I think with this one, we had quite a lot of creative license to take it into areas that it wouldn't necessarily have been if it was another brand. So again, it's what type of brand you're working with, who you're working with. But on this particular piece, it was quite refreshing to kind of go with something that, you know, you could just take it away from what it is that it stands for and give it something else. Yeah. But we answer briefs based on how the client, you know, what they allow us to do. Really. We'll push as much as we can, but obviously, you know, it's about their brand as much as it is what we're doing.
Absolutely. How did you choose
your model? It was a lot of hard work, actually. We put an ad out and we had loads of people apply it, and we, you know, selected from those people. We had a casting in different in a studio basically asking for them to try on these different clothes and to kind of perform, if you like, what we were asking for. And from that, we found this amazing model, Marissa Coleman, amazing model. She's done quite a lot of stuff internationally. And you know, as soon as we saw her in this outfit, we knew. It's just like, it just straight away just clicked. And it's like, okay, we have to use this lady here. She's fantastic. Other models we used, they brought different things to it, but this one just, you know, it was just like automatic. That's kind of what we saw when we first saw her. I thought, we don't need to look anymore.
It's got to be exactly. What's the biggest challenge?
I'd say time was probably one of the biggest challenges because we weren't just doing that particular scene on the day. We were doing other things, photographs of a whole catalogue of clothing, and also we were doing some other little gift type for a range of clothes that the designer had. So time was really against us, but we wanted to capture this piece because we knew that it was one of the stronger pieces of the day, and time was just disappearing. You know, when we got to the studio wasn't ready, so it was being painted. So there was a lot against us, but you know, I think a lot of thinking on your feet and kind of making things happen was that day, just like things just fell into place. And then you knew that you had a strong piece, you know, when you left, and everybody was really, really on the case to kind of get the best out of the day. So it was really good.
What are the elements that you think make a really effective fashion film?
I think for me, I like story. I like story and I like emotion. So I like things that get into people's kind of psychological, you know, thinking and how they kind of, I suppose, relate to a piece. You know, I like when you can move people, you know, and what it is you're delivering has a message, whether it's something that is relevant to you or relevant to another set. It's something that, you know, does say something. So for me, I like those pieces. But at the same time, beauty, I love beautiful things. I love things that really capture your imagination. You know, things that are bold and brave and never been seen before. That's what I like.
So what's next for you?
I'm doing some short films, trying to put all of those ingredients into short films.
Yeah.
More fashion films. More creative direction with other artists, writing a potential feature film with another producer friend of mine. And we're just pushing the narrative, really, pushing all of the story and all the above, you know, so whatever I make will be beautiful, have, you know, conceptual ideas, something that hopefully has not been seen before. But then on the other hand, I've also got children's products that I'm working on, children's book that I've just written. So creativity is the key to everything that I do, and that's you know, I look in areas for things that I don't see, and then I try to do it, you know, because you can't wait to have someone else do it. Try and do it yourself. So that's what I do.
Can you give us any insight into what any of these projects might focus on?
The children's one is a live action animation piece that I'm trying to put together. Get funding for, which is literally about two sisters, and they come across something that turns them into animated characters, but it's from a London perspective, and it's kind of making that, you know, a fun piece for children and the family. It's a family piece. The other feature film I've done a pilot for, which is like a short film at the moment, that's out, called The Date, and that's about female who's getting, I don't want to give away the plot too much, it's kind of about, it's a twist. I like to do things that have twists in them as well, so you know, you might see, it's not everything we see is what you think it is, you know, and I think life is like that, so you know, you go out there and you see the world, and a lot of the time you come out the door and you're talking to somebody and what they're saying isn't actually what they are and so on and so forth, but it's kind of that type of situation in a short film about words, which is quite interesting.
Oh, wow.
Which
okay.
is quite interesting. So that's what the short film that I may turn into a feature is, and it's really, it's again trying to get funding for that.
Yeah.
It's doing quite well in the short film area at the moment, you know. So those are the main things on my table.
Yes,
well,
lots going on.
Absolutely.
What would be your advice for aspiring filmmakers?
I would say be brave and know what it is that you want to do, as opposed to thinking that someone has to tell you, okay, this is what you need to do. I think if you need someone to tell you what you need to do, your journey is going to be constantly chasing. You don't want to chase, you want to be the one that's chased. So by doing what it is that you believe in and that you are 100% passionate about, you stop thinking about what someone else is going to say. Oh yeah, maybe try this, maybe try that. Mm-hmm. Do what it is that you believe. And I've only found that out in the last 3-4 years. Mm-hmm. So I'm in a much stronger place in terms of what it is that I do. I think that's what I'd say to any young film directors or producers.
Yeah. Good advice. Well, thank you very much for your time today.
Thanks for having me.
It's been lovely to chat to you.
You too.
And I wish you all the best in the future.
Thanks very much. Thank you.